Cypress Mountain to the north of Vancouver, and fine dry conditions on the floodlit course for the men's moguls. A crowd of 9,000 came to watch, and the atmosphere was electric. Among the 20 qualifiers, Brian Wilson of the United States. Dale Begg-Smith of Australia, the big favourite. And trying to win Canada's first ever gold medal at home, Alexandre Bilodeau. So Brian Wilson taking on the steep slope covered in a rash of bumps or moguls and two big jumps. And that was a good one. Two sets of marks would make up the score, one for sheer speed, the other for the quality and the difficulty of the jumps. Approaching the second one. An Iron Cross 720 nicely landed to round off a fine run. The third best in qualification, the 21-year-old American, a man who enjoyed the game of ultimate frisbee, had come to Vancouver looking for the ultimate prize in mogul skiing. Brian Wilson, his score, 26.08. It was a good performance, but not quite good enough for first place, because in the run just before his, Dale Begg-Smith had gone even better. Begg-Smith, the World Cup leader and favourite for the gold. A cross backflip. The Australian was the reigning Olympic champion, surprisingly only fourth in qualifying, but this was the final. This was the run that mattered. A 720 spin, two complete rotations, and Dale Begg-Smith crossed the finish line to the cheers of the fans. The reigning Olympic champion was not going to give up his crown easily. The moguls are a discipline requiring patient training and nerve to perfect the big jumps and strength and endurance to absorb the impact of the bumps. The skiers keeping their upper bodies facing straight down the hill as their lower bodies and their skis turn constantly. And Dale Begg-Smith, a proven master of the craft. He had an Australian passport, but he'd been born and raised in Canada, first learning mogul skiing at the age of four at nearby Whistler. And this perfect landing helping him to a score of 26.58. Dale Begg-Smith in first place. But would it be enough? Would he retain his Olympic title? This was Alexandre Bilodeau of Canada. A beautifully executed jump. And Bilodeau, the World Cup title holder, was absolutely flying down the hill. Second jump, approaching fast. An Iron Cross back layout, a brilliant run from the 22-year-old. He'd finished down in 11th in Turin 4 years earlier, but this run was in a different league altogether. As a teenager, he'd competed in aerials as well, but he decided to focus purely on the moguls, and he had improved dramatically in the pre-Olympic season. Working with a psychologist to help repeat the relaxed performances that he produced in training in the heat of competition. So, he'd quit listening to music before an event. He'd quit paying attention to the other competitors, and this was the result. Alexandre Bilodeau, one of three competitors from the province of Quebec, about to light up the Canadian night sky. A score of 26.75, he'd done it. The same jumping marks as Begg-Smith, but his phenomenal speed down the course had made the difference. The last to go would be Guillaume Colas of France, but he'd miss his grab on the second jump, and so Bilodeau was the champion, becoming the first ever Canadian to win an Olympic title at home. The men's moguls bronze medalist, Brian Wilson of the United States. It was silver for Dale Begg-Smith, the Australian, unable to hold on to the title that he'd won in Turin 4 years earlier. And pretty miserable. And the number one on Cypress Mountain, Canada's own Alexandre Bilodeau. Joy for the mogul man and relief for the host nation. The Canadians hadn't won a single gold at the Montreal Olympics in 1976 or at the Winter Games in Calgary in 1988, the only country to host two Olympics without taking a title. Now, on day two in Vancouver, Alexandre Bilodeau had finally given the nation what they desperately wanted, that elusive Olympic gold medal.